Guys, welcome back to the next game in the 4-year anniversary video. This is called Homebrew Patent Unknown. Now this is a really cool game as well because you also get to create your own like contraptions and like vehicles and such. So I'm going to make a simple car. It's kind of like Scrap Mechanic, I think, only more advanced, more intricate and complex. So I'll just make it be like 8. And 8. 8 and 8. Sorry, I don't know what's going on with my throat. Anyways, so yeah, let me just go like this with the wheels. Amazing description or explanation. We just go like this with the wheels. And so then just gonna go like this. And this is like a good basic chassis, I guess. And then we need to get out these and like just block it out. And then I'm gonna take a seat like this and just place it down. And then we gotta go like this. Oops. Like that. Like that. I'm just making it wider. Like that. Like that. Right. So I'm just going to quickly kind of lay this out. So we gotta go like that. So I laid out like how the wheels are, and then one thing I don't like about this game is how it says it has like a an undo and redo thing, but it really doesn't. It doesn't work. It's weird. So yeah, I'm just gonna go like that. Go like that. Right. So this is like the basic thing. Right, and so that's going to need to move. So I can probably just move this back a bit. Right, and then do is just go like that. Right, turn off symmetry again. It's gonna have every other seat. It's gonna have at least 2 seats. Right, and then go like Actually, what I'll just do now is I'll just move the whole thing back, I guess. Tiny bit, that way it'll all work out. Okay. So this is a pretty good basic chassis, I think. We obviously can't do anything with it yet, but I think I can honestly kind of set it up. So obviously these are all going to be brakes. Right. So now I've got that. But now we need to add an engine into it. I will use... I'll make it be a diesel, because why not? Right, so now we have that. We're also going to need a fuel tank. I'm going to make it be like a truck. I remember seeing something on with the, one of the examples, how they did something kind of like this. I found it interesting, so I'm going to try to recreate kind of what they did. 1, 2, 3, 4. Go boom. Oh yeah, and then 5, I can actually do that. Perfect. 3, 2. Right, so there we go. Now I got that. Now we need to go into gearing. And, go underneath the car, I guess. I don't remember what you know. That, then we go like this with the gearbox. We go boom, 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 boom. Right, so now we need, I do not know what's going on with my throat, but this has been happening, like, the past 2 days. I don't know. So then we just need a battery, so I've got that there. Yeah, I think that's all we need for now. So I'm gonna move the battery up here, that right up there, boom, 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 right fuel tank, left fuel tank, engine itself, small transmission, single gearbox. Alright, so now we take these two, we go like that, so it all sort of circulates. I don't usually do this. I've always just started kind of doing this a bit. Yeah. And then we put the activate into the activate node here, and then throttle into throttle. And drive shaft into the small transmission, and then the small transmission's drive shaft into the single gearbox. We take the single gearbox's drive shaft and put it into, well, I'm going to be putting it into just like how I usually do. I'll put it into all of the wheels. All-wheel drives, you know, so it'll be all-wheel drive. And we have the 12-volt battery, we put the power into the electric output into the input of the power. Now that should be just about everything. Oh, no. Sorry, I always forget this. We have to go with the up. We have to go into small transmission, and then where it has gear up, we put that into gear up. And gear down goes into gear down, and I can go straight lines and save it as. I don't know. Warrior vid chassis vehicle. I don't know. Right, so now we go F3, CPU 1, disappear these wheels, like, kind of really much more down. That's probably because of the engine. That would make sense. Right, now, anyways. So now I'm going to go 2 and 2, I should probably make that, probably make that go more like this, 2 and 2, and then put 2 and 2 together, huh. There we go, up maybe with a bit of a slant like that, and go that. Something kind of like that, and then go like boom. And go like that. That kind of looks cool. I mean, I don't know. Right. So now we have that basic start. Right. Wish the undo button button would work, but it doesn't. No idea why it wouldn't work, but it doesn't. Two, three. Excuse me. And that. Kind of a weird design, but I kind of like it at the same time. Right. So there we go, there's that part done. I do not, also just for the record, I have no idea what I'm making. I'm just kind of making. 1 over by 2, like that. Go. Boom. 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 Like that. And also, just for the record, I've never really made something like this. I'm sort of experimenting, I guess. I don't know. So I guess just something like that would be okay. Go over like that. I'm just making the basic like structure of the car, whatever. I'm thinking of making it be like kind of a Hummer-esque vehicle. Here's where I need to use this way of doing it. Wait, there we go, that's all of that part. And now I can go into here, right here, and fill this part in. I can also go in and fill in that part. There we go. And there we go. Boom, 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 boom. I can go like that. I can go boom. Oops. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, and boom, 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 boom. Ah, my throat. So there we go. That part. Right, so now I need to go up here. Like that, and I use glass. Go boom, boom, Let's see if that worked right. Turn off the glass part again. Right, so now it looks a bit like this. It looks better. Alright, so now I've got those parts done. There we go, so symmetry enabled, so I could have done that anyways. Right, wonderful. Wait, they have glass versions of these. Right, so I think that is just about everything. Now we can test it out. It's gonna be fun. Right. It's like a dragster. Okay, cool. Right now, anyways. So now, we got that stuff done, right? But that's not all. Since this is such a big vehicle, I'm going to do a couple things. First of all, what I like to do in general is, that like that, right? So additional text, yes, mouse per hour. Right, and then to the right of it, it's gonna say year. Actually, that's gonna be right there. So, first of all, this is the bottom one. And this is the top one. We're also gonna need a speedometer. I'm gonna place that right. Hold on. I'm gonna place that right over. If I can, over, oh, come on, oh, just let me place it, okay, oop, there we go, right over here, and go boom, and go boom, and go boom. Right, and then I'm going to go into here. For the speed system is set to miles per hour. I'm simply just going to, right, so this is the bottom one, and then this is the top one. So this one right here is going to go speed. And for this one, it's going to have the RPM, or not that, sorry, the current gear ratio go into there. Yeah, we're going to save it. Right, so now that works. The other thing we need to do is have working lights, you know, because we're going to need them if we want this car to actually be, like, legal or whatever. So, I'm going to go into the lights. I'm going to make two be right there. And we're also going to have, oops. Into their respective areas. So there we go, there's that part. And now all we need are some front lights. Right, so there we go. And now what I'm gonna do, I'm simply just going to select these two and move them back where they're actually supposed to be, which is like over here. Because they were like in front of the bull bars, then those wouldn't be it, I think. Alright. So anyways, that is the all the way over left, middle, left. Yeah, all the way over left. Middle left, all the way over right, middle right. I hate whatever I have. This cough or whatever, I don't know. Let me go to that one, this top and then bottom. Right. So, now, you need to have an add object, electric select, actually no, electric switch, I think. Yeah, and then we're also going to need a, an if logic box, and also a value box. So, set this value to -1. Put it into B. Actually gonna need another value box set to 1. Now we set it to straight use straight lines as well. I just like to do that. And then value box, this one was that we set to 1. We put it into if A equals B. And then we take the if logic box A input and put it into the small transmission's current gear. Rather, we take the small transmission's current gear output and put it into the input A of the if logic box. There we go. Output into the if logic box. Power comes from into the electric switch. I mean, from the if logic box into the electric switch. 12-volt battery power goes into the electric switch, and then we take that power and we put it into here, and I'm pretty sure that was an extremely confusing thing to say or understand, or just really confusing, whatever. But so the point is, if this small transmission is at -1, then these lights will turn on. It'll switch the power on or off, right? Now we need another one of these. One of these. Another one of these. We don't need this one though. And then we set if A is equal to B, and then B for here. And we go up to A and we set it into the brake. Oops, not the handbrake, the brake. Now, if the brake is on, then this will work. What's going on with those lights? What is doing that? What is making it blue? Isn't that weird? I don't know. Anyways, it's weird. Who knows? I don't think it's doing it anymore. I don't know. Anyways, so let me take the if logic box and we put it into the electric switch. We take the power from the electric input from the electric switch, connect it to the output of the power from the 12-volt battery. We take that output from the electric switch. there's the lights again. I don't know. And then we put it into both of these. And I think we should also take the red input and set that for all of them. That way they... all will be red when we are using the brakes. Right, perfect. So now... it's this bucket seat to be smooth output. We could save it. And also, if is seated. I think this one might not even need a whole thing. We could just put it like that. Go like that. Alright. So now that it is activated, we can go in and just turn it on. Okay, perfect. So yeah. Now I can save this. And then we can go out to here and we can work on this part. So we're gonna make this up to 3. Oh, that's way too big. 2. Why not 10? 1. 1.5. 1.25. That might be about good. 1.25. 1.125. 1.15. Just 1, seriously. Not even that. 0.75. Is that 0.8, right? So down 0.95. 0.45. And then both of these at 2.45 for the width. Like, none of the keyboard shortcuts in this game seem to work. I don't know. Except for the except for the ones with, like, the menus, I guess. But, like, Control-S and stuff, that doesn't... I don't know. Alright, CPU 1. I say this looks pretty cool. Right, so now, it actually is kind of moving. I don't think that was there before. I don't know, maybe it has and I just never noticed it. I don't know. Well, I'm pretty sure I've noticed that. I don't know. Anyways, so I'm now... just gonna go like this. Suspension distance. Try it at 1, oh yes. 10. I can only get to 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. What would this be like? I don't know. Uncomfortably weird is what it would be. That's actually kind of cool. Anyways. Yeah, that's obviously too far, but... five. 1. 0.75.5.25. Isn't that what it was at before? Or something like that. Diameter 1. Thousand. Let's try that. Don't know what that'll do, but who knows. Maybe it'll make it be so that the front doesn't go up so much. Or down so much, rather. Either that, or I'll just need to balance it out. Right, what would happen if I set that? To 2,000 again. I'm forgetting it. Can't save. Let's control S. I think it does look pretty cool though. I mean, no. So anyways, so now I can hide all those parts. Just go in and select everything. Or not, okay. Right, I think that's almost everything, is it? Nope. Keep on thinking it is, but nope. Let's make sure. Okay, So that's the entire frame. So now it should look something like that. You know, it doesn't look too bad, but now what I want to do is I want to go over to here. I want to paint these dark metal bits. Like that. So now I just need to make the whole chassis part. The right color. I don't know why I doesn't want to do it symmetrically today right now, but I don't know. Right, so there's that part. Now all we need to do is get this part all filled in. That part. So that should be that should be in roughly everything. Yeah. So now I can unhide the hole and hide the frame and just get to work on painting this all the right colors. So I'm gonna start off by just painting literally every single last thing this one color first. And then I'm gonna go around. So, yeah. And then I'm gonna go and repaint them. Right. So this is, I think, everything. Yeah. So this is what it's looking like now. Not too bad. But now, yeah, now I gotta make sure that everything is right. It's already looking better. So there's that part, and I might even just, for fun, kind of, Make that part be like that. Right. So here we go. Now what I want to do is I want to go like this. And unhide the parts as well quickly. And just go and completely connect it up right there. Right? Just like that. Right, now that we've got that like that, I can go in like that, and like that, and like that. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, boom, sorry. Boom. Boom. And then go boom, boom. Boom. That doesn't look right. Boom. 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 Right, now we go like boom. Boom. Boom, 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 boom. Right. So now it looks a bit more like this.
And we're having them with the sloppy jaw, right? Probably about 3. Are you okay?
Yep.
You seem like tired or something.
Right, and then...
So they'll
be done in like less than 20 minutes. All right. Go like that. Now I'm just going to go into here and turn on the hide the parts. And I'm just going to paint up these the right color. Like so. Right, so now that should all look good. It shouldn't really interfere with that at all. Right, perfect. The only other thing I think I can see that's wrong is that this doesn't appear to have that. Oh, now it does. Now I can disconnect these all up like that. And go boom. Right, so now that's all done. Now that's all done. I can start. Oops. Oh wait, what? No. No, no, no. Start work. Sorry, on this right here like that, and then right there, right. so now we got the start of our interior. And I'm gonna unhide that again. And I'm gonna go boom. Go boom. Go boom. Boom boom. Boom. Go boom 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 boom. Go boom. So now. That was looking pretty good, I think. But now we're on to the main thing I was going to do before, which is we're going to logic. Wait, no. Yeah, not logic. Other, I think. Other, and then we get out the CCTV camera, and we're gonna place it like right there. We're gonna kind of hide it a bit, slightly. Wait, okay. Oh, poopy. Okay. I messed up on the... Somehow the coloring went all weird. I mean, it does that, but like... I don't know. It's weird. Right. So, CCTV, select it, move it, go boom, go boom, go boom. Alright, that's all I'm going to do for that part. Alright, and then we go into the CCTV display, and we just like place it down. I'm going to be placing it down right over, if I can... actually get okay, it's going over here for now. I'm gonna move it back, move it up, move it back a bit more. Okay, shift it over. Okay. So there we go. Now we're gonna go into here. Right? CCTV display. I don't mean to do that. Right there. Yeah. I'm actually going to save this quickly. So yeah, so that's the CCTV display, right. So we actually need to take the one for the reverse, right? We can take this one, and take its power, and put it into the display. However, the actual CCTV itself, actually that will also have it. Wrong one. That one, I think. Yeah. But then the activate. Go right there. And right there. This one's not. Perfect. Right, perfect. And then now. That is all good. Now, I'm going to add in the number plate. One both right here and also one right the way back here. Oops. Darn it. Sorry, and also one right there. Move it back. I'm gonna give it its title. I don't know. I think I usually do this, I don't know why. So yeah, and then we go there, we go over there, like that, boom, you go shift, like that, we go, then, that is a little dumb. So now, it's just about everything. I actually forgot about this somehow. I do kind of like that one, but I think I might actually go with this one, even though the Chrome was what I was going to originally pick, I think. I think just go like that, like that. Yeah. I think that's just about everything. Straight lines. Save it. Yes, it still does it, so what I shall do then. Just, this thing is too big for, like, that's huge. Wait, so I could have just done that. Oh, that's weird. I never noticed that. Right now that part's underpowered, or overpowered rather. That's right, so now since we did that, all I need to do for this, for these lights, for the brake light, where are they, where are the brake lights, which ones are the brake lights? Which ones are the brake lights? Right. If A is greater than B, when B 0.1. This go into that. Unlink the red, link it up to the brake. Straight lines, yes. Save it. Oop, that was probably loud. Sorry. Right, so I think that's just about everything. Except for one other thing I was going to do very quickly, which was, even though this would be kind of weird, probably change... not to that, but to, you know what, no, I'll keep it classic, even though you won't really be able to see which gear you're in. Save it. And there we go. Right, so I made a few modifications to it. Oh man. So now it's a 5-seater. Oh man. And it also has a bit better of an interior. So here we go. So, yeah, so we have that, and now, I'm gonna actually try to make it an automatic. Alright, so I was going to add in some other stuff, but it turned out not to work, right? So yeah, but this is what it's been a while, but so kind of wasted time I guess, but I don't know. So here's what I have. This is what, if you want to go into reverse, you can, and it'll have the reverse. I think it's pretty good. So yeah, I mean, I think it's pretty cool. But I have other ones as well. What was the first one that I made? This one, Car 01 first. I don't even know if I actually made this. I think I might have just. I probably made this. I don't know. Right, and then there's this thing. I don't really remember this, but I must have made it. Oh wait, no, I didn't. I thought I hadn't. It's a template for something else. The lights don't even work right. I knew I hadn't made that. Right, yeah, epic car second, like, of course I called it that. Right, so this was the first car I think that I actually ever made. Or not the first car I ever made, but the first like proper car. Wow, this is red. There's this thing. Now this even kind of looks weird now that I see it. Some sort of SUV, I think, but I don't know why it's like that. Yeah, that thing which didn't work. Did this thing work? Obviously not. I think at this point all of these I've made. This thing was way too overpowered. Just a simple little part or whatever. think it was meant to be a go-kart, but it didn't really look like one, probably. Yeah, it's probably dragging on the ground, that's probably why, I don't know. But yeah. So, let's try to make a go-kart or something. You know, so. Oof. Yeah. But, what was this? So, wait, this thing. This is one of the first, like, really proper cars I think I've ever made. Have a battery pack in it? I think it does. But it's like meant to be some like little like legal but like kind of like a I don't know, it's a barely legal car. Like it's a very basic, not barely legal, but like very basic car. And it has like the percentage of that. That took a long time, but it was cool. And if you stop and just wait, since it has the solar panels on the top. Should see that it should soon takes a while, but it should. Maybe if I just turn it off. Should happen. I think it actually does have also like regular batteries or a regular battery just to like power everything else, or unless it doesn't, it probably doesn't. I don't know. So there's no glass right there. I thought I had it in glass there. Oh, that's dumb. Oh, no, because I'm not looking right through the... Yeah, no, there's definitely glass there, and then it doesn't look like there's someone there, even though there is. There's definitely some there. Anyways, my point is, it does actually work. It takes a long time to charge up, though, but... It does actually work. Hopefully that was a little enough charge that it will actually do it a bit faster. Should be out enough that it should actually hopefully do. I don't know. I'm not gonna wait. The point is, does it work? Yes, it does. Look. And that goes into here. See, look, it actually does. Right now, it currently sits at 99.33%. Is there? .34, see, it went up. That's my point. It actually does work. But yeah. I mean, I think it's cool. That's right, the gas, tuck tuck. This thing. Another legal, another very basic, barely legal, this one definitely probably is barely legal kind of car. I don't think it even has a speedometer. I think cars might actually need that, but I think it did. So yeah, and then we also have, where is it? I feel like there should be the full one of these. Unless this literally is all I did with it, probably, because that other one I think was the only one that I really worked on. Yeah, that's right. I was thinking I should have made that shell first. Anyways. So yeah, this one's essentially exactly the same as the gas tuck as it was before. It's electric. Anyways, so yeah, and then we also have, the milk float. This one actually sounds kind of cool. Don't know why the things don't work. That's literally just the chassis of it, with cab, does that come with the lights? No, this is literally just the bare bones, I don't know, but then we also have the delivery vehicle version of it, this one might be a tiny bit faster, I don't know. Right, this one actually has working stuff, and it has a working reverse. Do those front lights actually work? These are like the front lights. Okay, I see they're just not, I don't know. E chassis. And we have E1, which I think is the crazy thing. Yeah, it was. Like a speedometer and everything, it was crazy. And then of course the newest thing, which I think is really cool. So thank you for watching this part of this video. This was Homebrew Planet Unknown. I'll see you in the next part. Bye.